Okay friends, next in this session, we are going to discuss the effect of hyperconjugation on bond order or bond length. Okay, so we'll write down here effect of hyperconjugation on bond order or bond length. Okay, so friends, we already know that this bond order is inversely proportional to bond length. Bond order is inversely proportional to bond length. So any one of these comparison, if you get, you can write down the other one also. For example, you see, with one example, I'll try to explain this. Suppose we have to compare the bond order of carbon-carbon double bond in this with the carbon-carbon double bond in this. Okay? So if it is alpha and beta, so we have to compare the bond order of alpha and beta. And if you get this, you can get bond length also. So to understand this comparison, what we'll do, we'll try to draw the hyperconjugative structure of this. If I write this molecule like this, the hyperconjugative structure will be what? This sigma comes over here and pi comes over here. Okay, so the hyperconjugative structure here, it will be CH2 double bond CH single bond CH2 negative H plus here. Okay, so we have to compare this bond, right? This bond we have to compare. So pi is converting into sigma, right? Pi is converting into sigma. So what happens here, we can have three hyperconjugating structure where we have the sigma bond present. Okay, and one structure has double bond here, but here in this, since no hyperconjugation present here, so for this molecule the bond order will be 2, right? But for this molecule, the bond order will be somewhere between 1 and 2, right? I think it will, if you see, since the hyperconjugating structure that we are getting here, in all those hyperconjugating structure, we have carbon-carbon single bond present here, right? So we can say the bond order of this carbon-carbon double bond here, it is close to 1, right? It will be somewhere between 1 to 1.5. But we are not again going to calculate the exact value, but we can definitely say that bond order value will be between 1 and 2. So if you compare the bond order here, the bond order of alpha is greater than bond order of beta. Okay? And we can also say, if you have the bond order, so bond length of alpha is less than bond length of beta. So bond order comparison, if you have, accordingly you can write down the comparison of bond length. Okay, so one thing we can conclude here, that if more number of hyperconjugating a structure in which the double bond is converting into single bond, then its bond order will be less. Suppose one example, there is no hyperconjugation here. Here we have hyperconjugation, right? So in this it is very clear. Since there is no hyperconjugation, bond order is 2, and here it will be between 1 and 2. But what happens if two molecule will show hyperconjugation? For example, if I take this two molecule, CH3, CH2, CH double bond CH2, this molecule, you have to compare the bond order of this, right? And the another molecule is this, I'll write down here, CH3 CH double bond CH2, this one. beta. Right, so these two bond order you have to calculate. Now you see, if here we have number of alpha hydrogen is what? 2. Number of alpha hydrogen here it is 3. And if you draw the hyperconjugative structure of this, so that will be CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2, negative charge, H plus we have here. And here it will be CH3, CH, H plus, double bond CH, single bond CH2, negative charge. Okay, but this kind of, how many this kind of a structure possible here, and how many this kind of a structure possible here? Here we have only two structure possible like this, where we have carbon-carbon single bond, because we have two alpha hydrogen. But here, there are three similar structure possible, where the carbon-carbon has single bond. So if you compare, since more number of hyperconjugating structure we have here, in which we have carbon-carbon single bond present, so if you compare the bond order of alpha and beta, so bond order of alpha is more than to the bond order of beta. Why? Because in beta we have more number of hyperconjugative structure where carbon-carbon single bond is present. Here we have carbon-carbon single bond, but here the number of structure with such bond is lesser in comparison. That's why the bond order of this is more than this, and bond length will be reverse the order of this. Okay, I hope you understood this concept that I have discussed here. If you do not have hyperconjugation, fine, but if you have hyperconjugation, then you have to check that whether the bond, how many hyperconjugative structure we have in which carbon-carbon single bond or double bond is present. According to that, you can easily decide. Suppose if you're comparing the bond order of this one and this one here, right? Suppose we are comparing the bond order of, I'll write down this star mark and this tick mark. These two carbon bond length if you are comparing, okay? So due to hyperconjugation, what happens here? You see, this sigma bond is converting into pi, single bond is converting into double bond, so bond order is increasing. Here also the single bond is converting into double bond order is increasing. But the number of hyperconjugative structure we have, in which we have this kind of bond, is more over here, right, in comparison to this. Here we have two such structures, but here we have three structures possible. Hence, we can say the bond order of this bond is more than to that of this. So bond order comparison, it always depends on what carbon-carbon bond you are looking at. Okay, that's why I have mentioned alpha beta and alpha beta here. Okay, so according to that, so you cannot actually say that because of hyperconjugation the bond order is decreasing, right? We cannot say this. It depends what carbon-carbon bond we are considering. Okay, so I hope you understand this. I'll write down few examples here. We'll compare the bond order then. Okay. Okay, so all these molecules, we are comparing the bond order. Okay, you can pause the video and solve it. I am discussing it now. Okay, so here you see, here we don't have hyperconjugation, right? So alpha hydrogen is 0 here. No hyperconjugation. Here alpha hydrogen is 2 plus 2, 4. Right? So we have hyperconjugation, because of that this double bond has tendency to convert into single bond, right? And hence the bond order of, we have to compare the bond order, right? So I'll write down the heading bond order, and bond length will be reverse of this. The order of bond length will be reverse. Okay, so because of hyperconjugation, this double bond convert into single bond, order of first will be more than to that of second. Number of alpha hydrogen here, 2. Number of alpha hydrogen here, 2 plus 3, 5. Okay, so more hyperconjugation here we have, where this double bond will convert into single bond. So bond order of first is more than to that of second. Here you see this bond order, correct? This one and this one. Here what we have? Resonance possible. Here we have hyperconjugation and here we have no effect, right? So because of resonance, what happens, this pi will convert, this bond comes over here, right? So we have conjugation like this, right? So this single bond has tendency to convert into double bond. This single bond has tendency to convert into double bond. Here we have hyperconjugation, double bond has tendency to convert into single bond, right? And here we have single bond. So if you see, the bond order of alpha is maximum, then we have beta, and then we have gamma. In beta, the bond order will be any value between 1 and 2, right? It is near to 1 in this. It is exactly 1, right? It is slightly more than 1, and it is what? Close to 2 order will be this, okay? Here again we have resonance. This pi will convert into sigma, and here we have hyperconjugation. Resonance is always dominating, right? Resonance is always dominating. This has more tendency to convert into sigma. Bond order of beta is more than to that of alpha. Okay. Now in this last question, you see this is alkene, right? So bond order is 2. Beta will have maximum here. Here we have resonance, right? So this bond order will be minimum and gamma will be in between. So because of resonance, if double bond is converting into single bond, the bond order is lesser than the hyperconjugation in which the double bond is converting into single bond. So two things you have to keep in mind here: the effect which is taking place, whether it is resonance, hyperconjugation, and because of that effect, whether the double bond is converting into sigma, into single bond, or the single bond is converting into double bond. Like here you see in this example, the single bond is converting into double bond because of resonance. Okay, that's why the bond order of alpha is maximum here. But here you see, because of resonance, the double bond is converting into single bond, right? That's why its bond order is minimum over here, alpha. Okay, so you don't have to generalize this thing that because of hyperconjugation or resonance, bond order increases or decreases, right? It depends on what kind of a structure we have and what bond we are considering, right? What bond you are looking at to calculate the bond order. Right, so all these are the discussion of bond order. Okay, one more example I'll show you here. Okay, this molecule you see, here you see we have hyperconjugation possible, and here we have resonance. Right, so because of resonance, what happens here? The sigma bond is converting into single bond is converting into double, right? This, if you draw the resonating structure of this one, you will get this structure. We have a free radical here, double bond. So single bond is converting into double bond. Here what happens, the hyperconjugative structure of here, it is, and we have H plus here, right? So again you see the sigma bond is converting into double bond. Single bond is converting into double bond. Okay, so both kind of things are there, right? But since the resonance is more dominating effect, so this molecule has more tendency to convert into double bond, right? And that is why the stability of this or the bond order of this is more than to that of the first one. Okay, so this is how we discuss bond order, and bond length will be what? Exactly the reverse of this order if you have to calculate the bond length. The next thing we are discussing here is Bredt's rule. right, what it says? It says sp2 hybridized carbon. Carbon at bridge head position is highly unstable. Unstable and not possible. sp2 hybridized carbon at bridge head position is highly unstable and not possible. What is bridge head position? You see, if I draw this structure, right? So if you have carbocation present over here on this carbon, right? So you see this carbon, or this carbon that you have here, it is what? It is now sp2 hybridized. If it is sp2 hybridized, then it should be trigonal planar. And to maintain this trigonal planar structure, this bond should come to this side, because trigonal planar is nothing but this structure. Okay, this one. Right? So this bond has tendency to come over this side, right? But which is not possible here, because this is connected with this carbon and this here, right? This is a bicycloding. Bicyclo compound, okay? So because of this, what happens, this positive charge here, what happens, we have maximum angle strain here, right? And because of that angle strain, this molecule is not stable, high angle strain. So that is what the Brett's rule is. This position is the bridgehead position. Is the bridgehead position. And at bridgehead position, sp2 hybridized carbon is highly unstable. Okay. One more example if I show you. This one. This is also unstable and not possible. Bridgehead position, not possible. What about this one? This is possible, this is stable. This is not the bridgehead position. You see? This is structure we have here, right? So this is possible. This molecule is also possible. Here also it is stable. Here it is not stable. The positive charge here, it is not stable. Okay. Even if I consider an alkene also like this, if the positive charge is not there, suppose I will give double bond here. This alkene is also not stable, because again it is sp2 hybridized. So this kind of a structure only, it is not possible. Okay. This kind of a structure is possible. This double bond, it is possible. Okay. So sometimes they'll give you this question, and they'll ask you which of these, you know, structure or carbocation does not exist or highly unstable. So what we have to keep in mind, at bridgehead position, sp2 hybridized carbon should not be there. sp2 you must remember. Don't remember this carbocation, because here you see it is not a carbocation, but it is sp2 hybridized. Okay. So sp2 hybridized carbon is not possible at bridgehead position.